Hello everyone, myself Dr. Lakshita West. Today I'm presenting my paper on prospective study of mineralization in the deep gray matter with age by using susceptibility weighted imaging. Basal ganglia exhibit increased susceptibility to mineralization because of their metabolic rate. Among calcium, iron, copper, zinc, manganese, iron is the most commonly deposited mineral. It helps play role in normal brain metabolism, but excessive brain iron deposition causes risk factor for degenerative diseases that in turn causes restriction of the blood flow, leading to neural tissue damage and hence resulting in further mineralization. Normally, the brain content of iron increases with age, and that too especially in the lenticular nucleus because of its high metabolic activity. Many studies have linked increased brain mineralization with several neurodegenerative diseases like Parkinson's disease, Alzheimer's, Huntington's, and dementia. And that is why understanding the appearance of iron deposition in aging brain is an important step in the interpretation of imaging in diseased brain. For that, we need a highly sensitive sequence like SWI. That is a very advanced MR sequence, which is performed on conventional MR imaging scanners. It basically based on susceptibility variations between tissues. Minerals like iron, manganese, copper, calcium, they interact and distort the local magnetic field and alter the phase of the local tissue. And this phase alteration is detected by the SWI sequence. This sequence makes use of the phase information, and it is created by combining the phase and the magnitude images. So the phase images can be used to quantify the iron deposition. And the presence of iron in basal ganglia correlates directly with phase and enhances the SWI contrast. So the aim of our study is to establish the course and pattern of mineralization in deep gray matter with age by using SWI. We performed this normal conventional MR imaging examination with written informed consent. It was a prospective study comprising of 100 normal individuals. Of them, 56 were males and 44 were females, and they belonged from age group 1 to 90 years. And at least 10 individuals were there from each decade. The study was performed on a 1.5 Tesla MRI Siemens Avento SQ engine. The routine MR examination sequences like T1, T2, FLAIR, and SWI were taken. The exclusion criteria for our studies were the contraindication to MRI, like any ferromagnetic implants or cochlear implant, and the history of acute or chronic cerebrovascular accident or any congenital brain anomalies or history of any head injury or brain mass lesion, and the patients who denied the consent. And the image analysis, the magnitude image were used to semi-quantify the iron. For that, we use single pixel signal intensities in the region of interest, like putamen, globus pallidus, caudate nucleus, substantia nigra, and red nucleus. Then the correlation and linear regression analysis were made, which correlated with age as continuous variables. And a p-value of less than 0.05 was deemed to be statistically significant. These are the axial and magnitude phase images showing of a 14-year-old normal male showing the subtle hypointensity in the globus pallidus region and the substantia nigra, and subtle hypointensity in the red nucleus region. And in the corresponding phase images, we can see the hyperintensities in the respective regions suggesting the iron deposition. These are the images of a 33-year-old normal female showing the increased hypointensity in the globus pallidus and substantia nigra and red nuclei with corresponding phase images showing hyperintensity in the respective regions. These are the images from a 60-year-old normal female showing hypointensity in the globus pallidus, in the putamen, caudate, substantia nigra, and red nucleus. So, apart from increase in the hypointensity of basal ganglia with age, a systematic pattern of mineralization was noted in putamen extending from the posterolateral to the anteromedial aspect. Similarly, in globus pallidus, we saw small hypointense bands called waves showing increase in number with increasing age. So, in our result, we documented increasing mineralization with age in all deep gray matter areas under evaluation with p values less than 0.05, indicating that there is a renal relationship between the mineralization and the increasing age. A brief discussion of our case. The brain iron content increases with age, and that too especially in the basal ganglia because of their increased metabolic activity. The SWI is a highly sensitive image sequence that correlates between age and decreased signal intensities in different basal ganglia nuclei. During the image analysis, a steep decrease in intensity were noted during the first two decades in globus pallidus, putamen, red nucleus, and substantia nigra, which plateaued by the fifth decade in globus pallidus and putamen. However, in red nucleus and substantia nigra, there was a gradual declining intensity throughout the life. The caudate nucleus, it showed less steep decrease with more of an intermediate and steady progression. Apart from that, the pattern of mineralization were noted in putamen globus pallidus, where putamen showed progressive posterolateral to anteromedial progression of deposition with increasing age, and globus pallidus showing increasing wave count with age. The limitation of our study was because of the confounding factors that included age-associated pathological changes in patients. Therefore, there is a need of a standardized quantitative grading system to distinguish between age-related and pathologic iron deposition. So, from our study, we concluded that SWI is a highly mineralization-sensitive sequence that can distinguish and quantify the areas of iron deposition. It also has the ability to assess and monitor individuals with iron overdeposition diseases. And there is a need of further study to quantize and characterize minerals in basal ganglia of both controls and diseased brains. Thank you.